Hi everyone, welcome back to another video of Late Late Customs. Today we're finally doing a mod on Jody's P20 VTEC, and it's a modification that's definitely gonna stand out compared to the rest out there. I wouldn't say it is scarce at the moment, but like I mentioned in my previous video, to get like these kind of stuff like into the country at the moment due to the COVID-19 pandemic entire situation, it's a little bit difficult, or should I say expensive. Jody got his hands on a set of LCA's, ESR bar, and a Peaks bar. Did I pronounce it right? ESR? ESR bar.
Yes.
We have everything here on the table. I'll do an unboxing, or Jody will do an unboxing on a time lapse for you guys. But we're laying out the tools here. We are equipped with some winter gear. We have some gloves for protection. When you're gonna work with the chick, you always gotta wear some very, very good protection, because otherwise accidents happen, you know? I'm trying to be cool, but it's not working out.
Oh my god! Okay, it's happening! Everybody stay calm!
It doesn't wanna fit, but anyways, we got some glasses here. It's not working out, guys. It's not. Jody, put on the protection quickly, the people can cheese, man. Jody's gonna put on the protections. Ah! Protectionist, nah. Because you guys were actually complaining a lot about protection, especially when we're grinding and working on cars. So I got us some gloves and I got us some glasses. So the next safety mod for us as people, a Late Late customers, or Late Late, the Late Late crew, yeah, we need some headphones, ear stuffy thingamajiggies. I'm gonna hit you guys up with a quick cinematics of the before of the car, because it looks absolute pathetic underneath the car. I don't think we will be fitting the sway bar back in the car, because as you guys know, I sprayed my mirrors white in the previous video. So we might use the leftover paint to spray Jody's sway bar white as well, which you guys know already, it takes a day to dry. So we might do that as well, and this time we're definitely gonna cover both cars, because we really don't feel for overspray on these cars at all, and especially Jody's car. It's gonna look like a navy blue Oreo biscuit. Let me meet you guys up with a quick cinematics of the car. Alright guys, now that you guys seen the cinematics, you guys seen everything, you guys seen, I literally have two pairs of pants on though.
What?
So, you're not gonna broke my optrek here. But we got the wheels off, we got the car on jack stands, everything is secure. Guys don't need to worry about our safety, we got our gloves, we might use the glasses, still thinking about that. We're gonna start removing everything off the car. It's mostly 14 nuts and bolts underneath the car. And we actually got some amazing hardware here as well. Here we have the ASR bar right here. So this is the ASR bar right here. That's the Peaks bar right here. For some reason, there's not ASR anywhere on here. I think this is like the wrong way around. It's supposed to be the other way around. This is how it looks on the other side as well. On mine, you see ASR in the middle, but on this one is actually clean, because I think Jody ordered the clean one. Obviously, by the Peaks, it's exactly the same like mine. It's just I have to stick on Peaks, but me and Jody actually have the perfect idea that we are going to remove the Peaks, and then we're actually going to put on a Late Late sticker on the Peaks bar. So I think that will actually work. And obviously we have the LCAs that here. These are the LCAs I actually ordered from Kurt Klein, but unfortunately he got me the ones with the triangles. So this actually makes Jody's setup completely different from mine, because his LCAs are different. He has the later edition Bixbo, which is a little bit thicker. He has a completely different ASR bar, so it's a complete different setup on his car. But what makes the setup like very very soft are these circles right here, because this is the look I actually wanted to go with the car. And like the material, everything is completely different compared to mine, because even the material on his LCA is a little bit more shinier than mine, as well as on the Beaks bar and the ASR bar. I'm not sure if this is a specific ASR bar, I'm not sure what bar this is. We're gonna call it the ASR bar. I'll be putting you guys on the stand real quick. Now me and Jody will be removing the factory stuff on the car. It's quite basic. On the LCAs, one right here, we have 1, 2, 3 bolts. That side, 1, 2, 3 bolts. Then everything comes off. You just have to remove one nut right there, one nut on the other side for the sway bar, and you have like 2 bolts on this side, 2 bolts on that side for the sway bar as well. Then everything comes off. Hello Rafa! We have everything here, we have all the tools up, and we're just gonna start stripping right away. Keep in mind, this is gonna be a very very gnarly look on Jody's rear end. This is what settles off every EP on his or her rear end. This is just completely amazing. Like for the look me and Jody are going, it's a very very similar look, because he's running with a 16 inch Vox, I'm running with the 16 inch Spoons, and we're doing everything the same but different. Same but different.
Same but different.
Let me get you guys on the stand for this to follow. Guess what time it is? It's comparison time. This what I have in my hand right here is basically that right there. So this bottom one, this one right here, this one in my hand is exactly the same one. So which one would you guys choose? Comment down below. I mean, like, definitely those LCAs right there. There's obviously way shinier. These ones, I wouldn't say throw them away. Definitely keep them, because these bushings in right here are actually plastic. You do have the option of buying like the rubber ones and then like compressing them in. Apparently they're like big after a year, but me and Jolie, we never drive a car. I mean, like, you can drive with them, but definitely keep an eye out on these bushings.
The poly ones, eh?
Yeah, you have to get the poly ones, yeah. It's not rubber, it's poly. Sorry, it's not rubber, it's poly. Definitely be aware of that whenever buying these LCAs. Before, after. And you guys don't want to know the after, like, on the car. I mean, like, I can give you guys like a little look of how mine looks. Jody's is just gonna look way better than this, because it's obviously brand new and LCAs are more shinier. As you guys can see this side, guys can see, I have the triangle LCAs. We will be respraying Jody's sway bar as well. His sway bar will be white, just like this. I use the exact same spray for my sway bar I'm gonna use for his. So it's basically gonna look exactly the same. Just I have the orange one in the back, Jody will be having all of them silver. Definitely gonna be worth it. Commercial break, Jody, but say it in now.
Coffee
break. Is it not gevaarlijk? So bitchy. We're gonna see how far we can get. I mean, like, we have all the bolts here. To be honest, guys, I have no idea how to like install this kit. I mean, like, I completely forgot how to install this kit. So me and Jody have quite some figuring out to do. I'm sure we'll be able to figure it out. Yeah, what do you guys think of the lighting? I mean, like, the lighting this far has been super amazing. And what's the time, Jody? I mean, like, it's quite late, no?
Yeah, it's a little dark outside.
Yeah, it's dark.
It's 10 past 8.
Ooh, look at how dark it is outside. Well, we have a shiny. Oh, is it for the Sony? Sorry, Sony Quran. Look at that comparison, guys. Yo, remember, what is that, bro?
Phil?
What the filth? Damn it.
It's 20 years, bro.
20 years old? Yeah, that's with
21 years old.
Bro, you know, no, they stole that out of my garage. My Elsa is. That's the reason why I don't have my originals anymore.
You want the cast 21st?
Huh?
The cast 21st.
Is your car, is your car 21st?
So give the 21st gift.
Holy shit. It's too early, buddy. Too early. No. Yeah, 21st. Yeah, it's a 1999 model, man. Nah, like that. 21st birthday in Zoom.
Perfect.
I think that's a perfect title. Well, guys, we have everything off the car. We have these. I'm not sure what you call this, but I think you call this like droplings, I think. It's for the soy well. But now the thing is, because we are not running this LSS anymore, it has this hole right here. But on this LSS, we're gonna have to use these threaded holes right here. And I struggled with this the last time with my LSS, so you literally need to like, you're not gonna use one nut on each of these droplings anymore. So what we'll be replacing the nut is this threaded hole right here. So we're gonna turn it in like this. Obviously it's best to actually buy new of these droplings. I actually struggled with mine, getting mine in this threaded hole. I think me and Jody are gonna use the middle ones because he's actually checking what I did, and I did mine like, well, almost a year ago. We have all this hardware right here, but me and Jody are gonna try and fit these as unique as possible and put you guys on a time limit for that while we will be struggling as well. So see you guys probably in 2 days time. With some struggling, it was actually way easier than mine. We got it all the way installed. I'm not sure if you guys will be able to see that. You guys can see it's flush. We actually got it in the first hole. So this one is the driver side LSA. That is the passenger side LSA. As you guys can see right there. Well, it's built like that and like that. That's how it's going to be in the car with the sway bar connected to those ends. This time it was actually very, very easy. With my car, I actually struggled and it was some figuring out. But this time, I knew exactly what to do. Me and Jody tightened it up that way, so if, make example, one of those actually broke off, then we can still remove it from the inside with the Allen key. Like, we just throw the Allen key through this threaded hole right here and turn it the opposite direction to loosen up that dropling. Like, I literally don't know what to call this, but I'll call it a dropling because they call it a dropling in a polo. So, this is called the dropling for now. And if you guys know what this is, please comment down below because I have literally no idea what you call this. We're going to continue with the installation. We're first going to start installing the LSAs. We're going to start off like by the further side, which is like the wheel. So we're going to start with the hub. This holds the hub into place. This holds the coilover or the shock into place. And obviously you connect this to the chassis of the car, which is like the bottom portion where the ASR bar gets installed as well. You have to install these two separately. And obviously before you put this bolt on, make sure you throw on this ASR bar as well. Me and Jody, we're just going to do that off camera real quick or on a time lapse. Fuck, why should we do anything off camera? And here guys, we have a Yalsa pot grease here. You guys wanted some grease anytime. It's a groot pot here. Like a groot pot, chicos. Like Jody.
So dip in the grease.
Jody, let us say it's a makkelijke job.
Hmm?
Let us say it's a makkelijke job.
Easy peasy.
Easy peasy, but it's time consuming. But
try him with ace.
Try him with ace, one of the techniques. You have sukkel, but ha ha. It's right, Jody. Yeah. Jody.
I'm gonna feel much better.
Well guys, you guys made it till the end of the video. Me and Jody finished off the car completely. We ran into one tiny bit of an issue. Is that the hardware that was given with the kit, we actually broke off one bolt, and one bolt was actually stuck on the car while we struggled to finish the job. Then we first had to figure out a way to get that threaded bolt removed, that piece that broke off, and it was the entire story. Eventually figured that out, and then we got the Peaks bar on, we managed to fit the Soy bar on our own way that looks best for us. As you guys can see in the cinematics before this, we literally finished the job, and I'm extremely happy with the job. I'm tired, Jody's tired, Jody, Tyron and Lisa already left. It's like 1:30 the morning, the Sunday morning, and the 15th of August, today's the 16th, the 15th of August, 8 o'clock, my video actually went live, and at that time, me and Jody were actually really busy with this car, so I didn't get time to post like anything on Instagram, whatsoever, on WhatsApp, on Facebook, so I will be only doing it now, and that's the reason why I'm most probably like uploading everything this late. Yeah guys, I hope you guys liked this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and please to comment something down below. Me and Jody actually put a lot of effort in doing this video, and in this exact same day we actually fitted my spoon mirrors, so it was like 2 videos in one day, so it's kind of exhausting. It's totally worth it end of the day. Definitely like this video, share this video to your fam, to your friends, to your local people out there, because I mean, like, the more attention we can get on the channel, the better the content will soon to be in the future. Of course, the more money, better the content, more mods, more project costs. Keep that in mind. This will be the end of this video, and peace out.